The Prime Minister's office announced on Monday that the Security Cabinet has decided to hold off moving forward to pass an expected law to authorize holding terrorist bodies in certain circumstances instead. Attorney General Avikay Mandelblit has convinced the Cabinet to ask the High Court of Justice for a redo of its ruling last week prohibiting holding such terrorist bodies. Be the first to know, join our Facebook page. Function, D, S, ID, var JS, FJS equal D get elements batag name, S, 0, if, D get element bead, ID, return, JS equal D createlement, S, js.id equal id, jssrc equal / connect facebook.net/n_us/all_jsnumber_xfbml equal 1 and app id equal 163414806897, fjs parent node insert before, js, fjs, document, script, facebook jssdk, last week, a three-justice panel of the High Court ruled that the state cannot hold onto terrorist bodies as part of a strategy to get Hamas to return both living and dead Israelis without an explicit law granting that authority. Two justices ruled against the state, while one ruled in favor. Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu and a wide range of coalition politicians had pledged to move fast to pass a law to authorize the government to hold onto terrorist bodies in certain circumstances. However, Mandelblit convinced the cabinet to appeal the ruling to a broader panel of the High Court, with 7-9 justices, on constitutional issues, in an unusual procedure that is both rarely used and rarely successful. The statement said that the bodies of terrorists will not be returned and that the principles which were put forth by the majority of the High Court are not acceptable, but that the legislative path was on ice until a broader panel of the High Court ruled on the issue in last week's decision. The majority gave the state 6 months to pass a law granting it the authority to hold onto the terrorist bodies that would comply with both related domestic and international law, or it will need to return the bodies. Regarding the key principles that would come into play with such a law, the majority, including Justices Yoram Danziger and George Kara, said that international law only permits temporary holding of adversaries' bodies in times of ongoing conflict. The court hinted that international law might allow a state to hold onto adversaries' bodies immediately after a battle in which the adversary was holding bodies of its soldiers from the same battle, but the court added that if this were possible, the Knesset would need to explicitly authorize it and set specific parameters. The court stated that vague provisions in Israel's emergency regulations, which had not foreseen the current scenario, could not serve as a legal basis in any event. The court said that in the case before it, the terrorists held by Israel may not even be connected to Hamas and were taken at an entirely different time from the Israeli bodies taken by Hamas. In recent years, the court has repeatedly ordered the state to return terrorist bodies, but usually the state agreed to do it, making Thursday's decision the first time that the court was forced to explicitly rule about the state's authority on the issue. Share on Facebook, share on Twitter tags, Court High Court of Justice Bodies Corpses.